Without wasting any time, which stud pattern should you buy, AG Pro or FG? If you play exclusively on natural grass fields and are looking for the most aggressive traction possible, buy the FG version. If you play exclusively on artificial grass or perhaps on artificial and natural grass in the same season but only want to buy one pair of boots and for whatever reason prefer a slightly more traditional stud pattern on natural grass, then you should go for the AG Pro version. Should I just end the video there? Today I have for you the AG Pro and FG variations of the Nike Phantom Vision 2 Elite in, as you can see, the latest white and I think laser crimson. Yes, the laser crimson colorway, which I have to say does look a lot better in person. This of course being the FG variation, which retails for $275. And of course the AG Pro variation, which once again is not available in the US. It is a European exclusive. I'm still not sure why Nike does this given the fact that they are an American company and so many places in the US pretty much play exclusively on artificial grass. Either way, they are available with international shipping, which is pretty reasonably priced by checking out the first link down below. Now, obviously, we already went over which one you should buy based on your situation, but if you're interested to know the details in terms of what is actually different between the AG Pro and FG versions of the boot, that's exactly what I'm going to cover in today's video, including how they fit and feel on feet. So if you're interested in learning more about these I don't think I've ever said boots in a video. If you're interested in learning more about these boots, please stick around, watch the entire review. And if you're interested in either of these for yourself, you can click the little pop-up in the corner of the screen or the first link down below that's gonna take you to the review page on my website where you'll find buy it now links with exclusive SR4U coupon codes to pick these up below their normal retail prices. Now both boots come in the exact same gray and black Nike box, nothing interesting there. And they also come with the exact same string bag, which is particularly interesting in that for whatever reason, they really remind me of these specific Nike Mercurial Vapor 5s, also available as a Superfly 1. Really like that colorway, wish I had them in my collection. As you can see, the bag is white with a black triangle and what is supposed to be laser crimson that ends up looking more pink than orange on the string bag for whatever reason. The swoosh and the Phantom Vision branding, black strings, white on the back of the bag. I really like the way that it looks. It gets a string bag rating of 57 out of 71.8. I can't believe people think those string bag ratings are a joke. Before we get into the specifics, I just want to comment on the colorway because this is not actually part of any pack, which is kind of unusual for Nike these days because they kind of give everything a pack name. This is just white, black, and laser crimson. And I have to say, it is by far my favorite colorway of the Phantom Vision 2 so far. I know in pictures it just looks like regular white, but hopefully it comes through in video. It has this nice pearl finish to it that actually looks quite premium with the heavy texturing that you have on the upper of this particular boot. I like the combination of white and black in the exposed Flyknit lace cover. I think that looks quite good as well. And then this laser crimson color, which is kind of orange in the right light and kind of pink in the right light, I think actually looks pretty good on the heel counter as a very subtle accent. The swoosh is just solid black on both the lateral and medial side. Very subtle Phantom Vision branding there in white. Of course, a nice large ACC logo. We love to see that on our Nike boots. The laces are in that laser crimson as a nice contrast, even though you can't see them while wearing the boots. And then the sole plate, as you can see, is white with laser crimson studs. As for the boots themselves, what exactly is the difference between the AG Pro and the FG versions of the Vision 2? And I guess starting with the uppers, they are exactly the same. Moving to the sole plates and stud patterns, this is where there's a bigger difference than I think a lot of people realize. As for the FG variation, you guys are extremely familiar with this. It's a carryover sole plate and stud pattern from the first generation of Phantom Vision. They have not changed a thing. TPU plastic outsole, decent flexibility to it. It does have this little extended lip around the forefoot and toe box area for enhanced durability. And then as for the FG stud pattern, it's a relatively aggressive layout. I know they kind of look like conical studs, but they have a little bit of a bladed edge to them on the inside. Then obviously you have some Mercurial-esque blades right here at the tip of the toe. Heel is all blades. This, quite frankly, is usable on artificial grass. I have personally done it, but I definitely do think that it has a little bit too much cling and quite possibly just provides too much traction, which does increase your risk of injury on artificial grass, which is something that I would think you're trying to avoid if you're watching a video like this. On natural grass though, the traction is really good. As for the AG Pro variation, it features a completely different plastic for the sole plate that's actually a little bit thicker, which is by design because artificial grass, especially an outdoor pitch, in the middle of summer can get very, very hot. So the thicker plastic is better suited to deal with that heat, where if you're using a thinner FT sole plate like this, it's gonna break down that plastic more quickly and you're more likely to run into issues with stud pressure, which should not be the case with the AG Pro variation. As for the stud pattern itself, as you can see, the layout is a little bit different, a lot more traditional in terms of having all conical studs, but they are somewhat unique in terms of having this kind of hollowed out center. And the tip here that you see in this laser crimson orange is actually a softer rubber material. So they have a little bit of flex to them. And the logic behind the flex is that it's going to have a little bit of a break in the grip. What you really don't want when it comes to traction is your foot digging into the ground and then being stuck. It's called cling, which is exactly what you're gonna end up with a lot of FG stud patterns that have more of a bladed shape to them, especially here at the tip of the toe. So you never wanna be planted in the ground and don't have that freedom to twist and pivot, because should you plant and your foot is stuck and you get bumped or you push off the wrong way, it is very, very likely, or at least the odds of this happening are a lot higher in terms of suffering some kind of a severe knee or ankle or possibly even hip injury. The AG Pro model also has a bit of an extended lip from the sole plate, again, for the sake of durability. And one other thing I'll say about the Vision 2 as an AG specific boot is that because of the lace cover and this seemingly unnecessary collar that honestly I wish wasn't there, when you're actually wearing the boots on artificial grass and you have those rubber pellets getting inside, because of the lace cover, as well as this tight fitting low cut collar, which you don't really notice anyways, it actually does a pretty good job of keeping those rubber pellets from getting inside your boots. I guess the best way to put it is wearing an AG Pro stud pattern on artificial grass feels a lot like wearing an FG stud pattern on firm natural grass. And again, your risk of injury is going to be not completely eliminated, but minimized using an AG stud pattern versus an FG stud pattern on artificial grass. And I realize wearing FG stud patterns on artificial grass is extremely common these days, but it's a perfect example of if everyone else is doing it, I might as well do it too. That doesn't make it right. And granted, I don't think that most people who do this even realize that AG stud patterns are a thing. Not everyone is a boot nerd after all. And two, it's not like Nike is making these things readily available, especially if you live in the US. So if you're watching this video and you're educating yourself a little bit, I definitely think that it's worth the little bit of extra cost, perhaps a little bit of extra hassle to get a hold of an AG stud pattern if you legitimately spend that much time playing on artificial grass. Because again, while you might never get injured wearing an FG stud pattern on AG, that one time you do is the one time that you're gonna wish that you probably had an AG stud pattern. If you have the power to potentially lower your risk of injury, I don't see why you wouldn't go and do that. And just for the sake of comparison, let's see what the weight difference is. Both of these in a size 9.5 US. We'll start with the FG variation. You can see that they weigh in at 7.9 ounces, the equivalent of 223 grams. Change the scale back, and we'll throw on the AG Pro variation, and you can see that they weigh in at slightly more, 8.15 ounces, the equivalent of 231 grams, which is a very small amount of weight that, trust me, you will not notice. A common concern that people have when it comes to stud pattern and sole plate variants is how much different does the AG Pro stud pattern feel versus the AG Pro stud pattern when the boots are actually on your feet. And to be honest, having these on side by side, if someone were to put them on my feet without me knowing, I would have a really hard time telling you based on feel which one was which, because they feel pretty much identical in my opinion. Flexibility of the sole plate is pretty similar. Maybe the AG Pro one is slightly more flexible, but it's a very small difference. And the thickness of the sole plate is not something that you really notice from a try-on perspective. As far as shape is concerned, that does not change whatsoever. So again, it really is just a matter of what surface you're gonna be using them on in terms of which one is going to be the best option for you. As far as overall fit is concerned, I really like the Phantom Vision 2. The internal quad fit system allows for plenty of, I guess, sock-like sensation from the upper, but without any added structure. That to me is the appeal of this particular boot. It really does have that super natural sock-like sensation if that's something that you're after from a knitted upper football boot. Wraps your foot really, really nicely in comparison to the original Vision. Seems to fit a little bit more snug. They've decreased the volume ever so slightly. Lockdown is quite good, and the boots as a whole are really, really comfortable. There's really not much to break in. As far as width is concerned, I wouldn't say that they are particularly wide, but they're definitely not super narrow either. I think they'll fit most people as long as you don't have excessively wide feet. And as far as sizing is concerned, I'm wearing these in my usual size 9.5 US. and the fit and the length is perfect. So if you're looking to order some for yourself, I would strongly recommend going true to size in order to achieve the best possible fit. Anyways, guys, that's it for this one. Hopefully you found this video helpful and informative. If you did, be sure to support it with a like. Again, if you're interested in either of these two boots for yourself, in either the FG or AG Pro stud patterns, you can click the first link down below. That's gonna take you to the review page on my website, where you'll find buy it now links with exclusive SR4U coupon codes to pick these up below their normal retail prices. If you have any questions, as always, leave them down below in the comments. If you are not subscribed already, make sure you hit that subscribe button along with the little bell notification so you get notified when the next new video goes live. You can find all my social media information linked down below in the description as well. Other than that, guys, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.